York Space Systems is ready to take off, expanding its Colorado production facilities to build innovative satellites. And joining me now is Charles Beams, Executive Chair of York Space Systems. Charles, thank you so much for joining me this afternoon. Why was now the right time to expand, and how are you trying to accelerate your company from here?
Hi, Kristen. Thanks for having me. What's going on is that there's the commercial technologies that drove the whole tech revolution are now making their way into space, and it's really revolutionizing all aspects of our business, all sectors of the economy. And the government was the first to kind of wake up to this, but companies, you know, Fortune 100 companies around the world are waking up to the fact that space technology is essential to gaining an advantage over the competitors. And at York, we're excited to be provisioning that for governments and companies around the world.
Mm-hmm. So I want you to talk more about that. I mean, a lot of people think of space, they think of NASA, they think of SpaceX, they probably right. think of Blue Origin now as well. They might think of some of the legacy companies as well, like a Lockheed Martin, for instance. What are the companies that you're working with? And explain this unique position that you hold in terms of how exactly you partner with them, you work with them to get these satellites into space.
Sure. Basically, what we do is we've designed a system, a platform that has multiple uses, right? Everything from remote sensing, taking pictures, to communications, to navigation, to weather prediction. All these things now really get a huge advantage when information is either collected from space or is transmitted through space. What we're doing is we're the people that build the actual systems for our customers, and our customers are everybody from media companies to everything, transportation companies. And it's very exciting because we're going now, our big announcement is going to being able to build, rather than tens of satellites at a time, we're going to be able to build hundreds at a time. And so that, which we call it a mega factory because of that, and we'll be able to build thousands per year, because that's where we see things going in the future. It's already halfway there now, and so frankly, we're a little bit behind in building out this this new capacity. So it's a very exciting time. The partnerships vary, everything from we build and do long-term leases for our customers to we just build outright constellations for them, whatever they need.
Let me just jump in here, Charles. I mean, explain how this might impact a consumer's life. I think probably the most notable example of satellites going into space, let's use SpaceX for instance, right, is to beam internet to all different parts of the world. That's the role of those satellites. How will consumers see their lives change or notice a difference because of these satellites that you're trying to help get into space?
Sure, I'll give you a great example. A lot of us are excited about the driverless cars and how that's all going to work. Well, the reality is that we need very precise navigation in order to do that. The GPS that we all know and love today, that I actually worked on when I was in the Air Force years and years ago, that's just not sufficient for the precision that we need. We get that precision from commercial, right? But rather than having 30 satellites in orbit, we'll have hundreds probably that'll be able to do this navigation. And that will enable very precise autonomous navigation. That's coming. That's just in the next couple of years. The internet from the sky is the Starlink and also Jeff Bezos with his ambitions. But what I find interesting is that these satellites are becoming so inexpensive that companies will be able to have their own Starlink. They'll have their own completely customized communication system very inexpensively. These are dropping now to the price of a computer themselves. The ones that we manufacture and sell, they're about $1 million a piece. So for less than $50 million, companies are buying, and small countries, frankly, are buying their own constellations.
Charles,
which they'll do all kinds of different business.
You know, one of the things that is astonishing to me is I'm seeing in some of our research here that your company is not venture backed. So
right.
Talk to me more about that. Was it bootstrapped? Obviously, it sounds like now you are dealing with the biggest companies in this space. Talk to me about that journey.
It's very exciting. We deliberately made a decision to not seek venture funding. I was very familiar with it. I ran Paul Allen's Vulcan aerospace company, and which is a big investment house. And so I was very familiar with the different financing options. What we wanted to do is we knew that we needed to move fast, and we needed to have team, complete, dedicated team players. So as you know, I'm the executive chairman of the company, and I'm a big investor. We did take on private investors, that folks that we personally vetted, other board members vetted. And so we have a very close-knit, tight-knit team that includes the board, and it allows the company in Denver to move very quickly, to be responsive to changes in the marketplace, and to actually, frankly, lead change. And so it's a very exciting opportunity for us. We've been able to do it. It's a quasi bootstrap, because all the people, some investors are actually employees of the company as well. So it's a very different approach. We're very excited about taking it forward.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about that, taking it forward. Is an IPO in the works by chance? Not venture backed, but I mean, you are expanding, and again, you're working with the biggest companies out there. Are you looking at an IPO?
Well, we, you know, I'll tell you, Kristen, we get approached all the time about an acquisition. Big companies want to buy us. We're not interested in that. Frankly, we're having too much fun doing what we're doing. We're all a bunch of just crazy space geeks that love helping to usher in like the new, you know, new generation into the space business. We love all the young folks that work. Most of the people, this is something else that's different. Most of the employees at York are under 30, right? And so it's a whole new generation. As far as an IPO, we're not opposed to it, but we'll know when the timing is right. But we certainly get a lot of interest from a lot of different folks about that.
We will be watching, Charles. I hope you will come back on this show. If you do see an IPO in the future, that's Charles Beam, Executive Chair of York Space System. Charles, thanks again.